Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. How are you, my students? My name is Shaima Bah. I am Quran and Tajweed teacher. Inshallah, I will step by step with you to learn Tajweed rules. In this video, we will study together a new Tajweed lesson. The lesson today, we will continue in studying the types of mad because of sukoon. أنواع المد بسبب السكون. Who can tell me how many types of mad because of سكون? Teacher. Two types of mad. Yes, very good. Great job. There are two types of mad because of سكون. مد لازم. مد عارض للسكون المد العارض للسكون and مد لازم المد اللازم we studied together مد عارض للسكون in the last video you can find the link of the video in the description today inshallah we will study the second type of mad because of sukoon it's mad lazim al mad lazim in this video we will study together three parts of mad lazim in the first part we will study together the meaning of mad lazim in the second part we will study together the types of mad lazim In the last part, we will study together examples about mad lazim. Let's go to the first part to study the meaning of mad lazim. Mad lazim, it's a type of mad because of sukoon. Sukoon may be in the form of shadda or normal sukoon. In case of shadda, we stretch our sound for 6 beats. المد اللازم the mad letter followed by مشدد letter which is present in the same word like الضالين or the mad letter followed by ساكن letter which is present in the same word like الأنا or ألف لام ميم. Now let's go to the second part in our class today to study the types of mad lazim. There are two types of mad lazim. Mad lazim كلمي and mad lazim حرفي. Let's start with مد لازم كلمي. المد اللازم الكلمي. There are two types of مد لازم كلمي. مد لازم كلمي مثقل and مد لازم كلمي مخفف. The first type is مد لازم كلمي مثقل. مد لازم كلمة مثقل means the mad letter followed by مشدد letter which is present in the same word like الصاخة الطامة you should make long sound with 6 beats The second type of مد لازم كلمي it's مد لازم كلمي مخفف. If a mad letter is followed by a second letter which is present in the same word, the reader is required to prolong the mad letter. It must also be prolonged no less than 6 beats. Examples. This is the only case in the Quran. It's Al-Ana. The mad letter followed by second letter, which is present in the same word. Mad lazim harfi. The second type of mad lazim, it's mad lazim harfi. Al-maddu lazim al-harfi. That means the type of mad which comes in the letters from alphabet letters which come in the beginning of the surah. In Arabic, it's meaning الحروف المقطعة, cut letters, like قاف صاد نون types of مد لازم حرفي. There are two types of مد لازم حرفي. مد لازم حرفي مثقل and مد لازم حرفي مخفف. Let's start with مد لازم حرفي مثقل. If a mad letter is followed by a مشدد letter, the reader is required to prolong the mad letter. This mad must be prolonged for 6 beats. Examples. Alif Lam Mim Sad. It's written as Alif Lam Mim Sad. And the shape of mad above the Mim and Lam and Sad. But it's pronounced as Alif Lam Mim Sad. In letter Lam, the mad letter followed by second letter. In Mim, the mad letter followed by second letter. In Sad, the mad letter followed by second letter. But in Lam Mim, the mad letter followed by Mushaddad letter. Mim second and Mim with short vowel kasra. So it's mad lazim harfi musaqal. You should make long sound with 6 beats. In Lam Mim, but in Lam and Mim and Sad, it's mad lazim harfi mukhaffaf. Alif Lam Mim Ra. It's written as Alif Lam Mim Ra. The shape of mad above letter lam and letter mim, but it pronounced as alif lam mim ra. The mad letter followed by second letter in lam. Mim, the mad letter followed by second letter, it's mim. But lam mim, the mad letter followed by mushaddad letter. You should make long sound with 6 beats. Where is mad lazim harfi musaqqal? It's lam mim. Okay? Not lam, not mim, lam mim. Lam. This sound. Mad letter followed by mushaddad letter. It's mad lazim harfi musaqqal. The last type of mad lazim, it's mad lazim harfi mukhaffaf. If a mad letter is followed by a second letter, both of them being present in the same letter, the reader is required to prolong the mad letter. This mad must be prolonged 6 beats. Examples. Kaf haya ayn saad. It's written as kaf haya ayn saad. And the shape of mad above letter kaf, letter ayn, and letter sa. But it's pronounced as kaf haya ayn sad. The mad letter followed by second letter in kaf. Ayn, the mad letter followed by second letter. Sa, the mad letter followed by second letter. You should make long sound with 6 beats. Please take care. The mad in the letters ha ya ta ha ra, it's compounded in the sentence hayyun tahur, is mad tabi'i that has only 2 beats. Why? It's not mad lazim. Why? Because ha, the spelling of letter ha in 2 letters, ha and alif, ya, the same 2 letters, ya and alif, ta, the same. Ha, ra. So if any one of this letter in the beginning of the surah, you should make long sound with 2 beats only. It's mad tabi'i, not mad lazim. like Hamim, Taha, Alif Lam Ra. Required the two mad lazim harfi. The spelling of the letter must be on three letters with a mad letter in the middle, followed by second letter which is present in the same word, like sad, qaf. Now I want to test your knowledge. Are you ready? Please send your answer in the comments. Who can read the next cat letters? Hamim, Ain, Sin, Qaf, Alif Lam Mim Ra. Awesome. I wait your answers in the comments. Now it's time to leave you. That's great to see you today. Please, if this video is useful for you, don't forget to make like, share, and subscribe. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.